Sir, we have a question on oxygen shortage. We are hearing about acute shortage of oxygen in different states, and there have been deaths due to lack of oxygen supplies. Is the central government planning on intervening to ensure the supplies of oxygen? What is the planning of the government?
ऑक्सीजन दो प्रकार की होती है, एक जो इंडस्ट्री में उपयोग की जाती है और दूसरी जो अस्पतालों में मेडिकल पर्पसेस के लिए इस्तेमाल की जाती है। तो मेडिकल ऑक्सीजन जो होती है उसको LMO कहते हैं, पॉपुलरली लिक्विड मेडिकल ऑक्सीजन, और जो इंडस्ट्री में यूज़ की जाती है वो इंडस्ट्रियल ऑक्सीजन कहलाती है। देश की प्रतिदिन ऑक्सीजन उत्पादन की क्षमता 6,900 मेट्रिक टन है, ये आज की क्षमता है। टुडेज कैपेसिटी ऑफ प्रोडक्शन ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इन द कंट्री इज स्लाइटली मोर देन 6,900 मेट्रिक टन। अगर आप आज सुबह के आंकड़े देखें, जितने लोग ऑक्सीजन पर थे कोविड की वजह से, तो 3.69% वर ऑन ऑक्सीजन सपोर्ट, 2.17 वर ऑन ICU बेड्स विच आर अगेन विद ऑक्सीजन, एंड 0.36% वर ऑन वेंटिलेटर सपोर्ट विच इज अगेन विद ऑक्सीजन। सो इफ यू एड दीज थ्री कैटेगरीज यू रफली गेट अराउंड 6% पीपल हु वर ऑन ऑक्सीजन बेड्स, वेदर इन ICU और इन ऑन वेंटिलेटर्स और इन ऑक्सीजन सपोर्टेड बेड्स। So what was the oxygen which was being consumed by these people plus the oxygen that is consumed by non-COVID essential health services where you also have certain surgical procedures. So if that is taken again, today's morning figure, that is 2,800 metric ton on a daily basis. And if you look at the industry's production in the country and their requirement for oxygen, it is 2,200 metric ton. So 2,800 metric ton for COVID and non-COVID health use, 2,200 metric ton for industrial use, that gives you a total of 5,000 metric ton consumption per day and a headroom of 1,900 metric ton. So speaking at the national level, there is absolutely no shortage of oxygen. In fact, there is a surplus today morning of 1,900 metric ton. Then what is the problem? The problem happens when at a facility level, aspatal ke star par, if you do not have inventory management, avashyakta is baat ki hai ki pratyek rajya ye sunishchit karein ki pratyek aspatal ke star par ऑक्सीजन का इन्वेंट्री मैनेजमेंट हो, पॉसिबल स्टॉक आउट्स के अलर्ट जनरेट हों ताकि ऑक्सीजन को रिप्लेनिश किया जा सके। राज्यों को जो ऑक्सीजन प्राप्त होती है वो दो माध्यमों से प्राप्त होती है, एक ऑक्सीजन को मैन्युफैक्चर करने वाली कंपनियां हैं जो हो सकता है उसी राज्य में हों या किसी और राज्य में हों, और दूसरे स्टील प्लांट्स हैं जो ऑक्सीजन भी प्रोड्यूस करते हैं, उनके साथ भी राज्यों के या अस्पतालों के एग्रीमेंट होते हैं। तो ये प्रत्येक राज्य को सुनिश्चित करना है कि उनके यहाँ इन्वेंट्री मैनेजमेंट बेहतर तरीके से हो। अगर शॉर्टेज होने वाली है दो दिन तीन दिन के बाद, तो समय रहते हुए रिप्लेनिशमेंट कर लिया जाए। भारत सरकार से जो मदद राज्यों को चाहिए वो मांगी जाए। हमने राज्यों के साथ इसमें विस्तार से बैठकें की हैं, उन बैठकों में स्वास्थ्य सचिव के अलावा सचिव डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज़ और डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल ने भी भाग लिया है, क्योंकि उनकी भी इसमें भूमिका है। और हमने राज्यों को ये कहा है कि वो राज्य के स्तर पर एक कंट्रोल रूम बनाए जो ऑक्सीजन की स्थिति की दैनिक मॉनिटरिंग करे। भारत सरकार के स्तर पर भी हमने एक वर्चुअल कंट्रोल रूम की स्थापना की है, जिसमें स्वास्थ्य मंत्रालय के एक जॉइंट सेक्रेटरी स्तर के पदाधिकारी और डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंडस्ट्री के जॉइंट सेक्रेटरी स्तर के पदाधिकारी और पेसो के एक अधिकारी और ड्रग्स कंट्रोलर जनरल के दफ्तर से एक अधिकारी हैं, इनके नंबर और इनके ईमेल्स पब्लिक डोमेन में हैं, ताकि राज्य सरकारें या संघ शासित क्षेत्रों की सरकारें या आम जनता भी अगर इस प्रकार की कोई जानकारी इस वर्चुअल कंट्रोल रूम को देना चाहे तो वो दे सकती है, ताकि ये उस पर कार्रवाई कर सकें। तो आज की स्थिति में हमें ऐसा नहीं लगता है कि कोई ऑक्सीजन की कमी है, आवश्यकता है कि राज्य इसकी सतत निगरानी करें और इसका रैशनल यूज करें।
रशियन वैक्सीन, रशिया में वैक्सीन बनाने की हिस्ट्री इज गुड, दे हैव बीन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग फॉर मेनी इयर्स, सो दिस वैक्सीन आल्सो वी प्रिज्यूम इज गुड, दे हैव पब्लिश्ड देयर फर्स्ट स्टडी ऑफ 76 पेशेंट्स इन द जर्नल लैंसेट, व्हिच इज शोइंग गुड इफेक्टिवनेस एंड गुड इम्यून एंटीबॉडी जनरेशन. This has been, there is dialogue going on between the, there is a high level committee of the government of India for vaccines, and that is in dialogue with the Russian and the Russian diplomacy and the Indian diplomacy in Russia, and we are trying to work out mechanisms because they have not yet completed a phase 3 trial. They have started a phase 3 trial, but to do a phase 3 trial of a product from outside of the country has to go through the regular processes of clearances from the regulatory agencies in India, and once that happens we should be able to start that.
34.
Could you please clarify emergency use authorization for vaccines and what that might mean for us?
Emergency use authorization is not only for vaccines, it's for drugs also. And it is a existing provision in the Drugs and Cosmetics Act of the country. Such provisions are there in the regulatory framework of other countries also. Now, having explained the rule position to you, the implication of emergency use authorization, it is an accelerated process which permits the regulator of a country to grant permission under emergency authorization, which is distinct from regular market authorization, which takes time, which requires more data on safety and efficacy to be shared with the regulator. One example would be US FDA giving emergency authorization to remdesivir. Similarly, emergency authorization to remdesivir was given by the Indian regulator also. The last part of your question in respect of vaccine, presently no one has applied for emergency authorization, so therefore the regulator does not come into the picture.
Sir, another question. What percentage of patients facing post-COVID complication? Do we have any data on this?
Sorry, what was the question?
What percentage of patients is facing post-COVID complications?
We do not have any centralized data on this, but we have received such information because our central government hospitals have encountered recovered patients who have come back with certain complications, and based on the information that we had and the technical inputs that we received from the JMG, which is a domain knowledge body headed by Director General Health Services, and the task force, which is again a domain knowledge body headed by DG ICMR and Dr. Paul, member health of Niti Aayog. Based on their inputs, we have recently issued a guidance note for post-COVID recovered patients, how to counter these complications and how to take precautions.
14.
There have been cases and studies coming out from Ahmedabad, Noida, Bombay on reinfections. What is the ministry's stand on reinfection of COVID? Have you received any confirmed cases that you'd probably like to share now?
Let's hear the scientific stand on reinfection.
As I said, I think it was asked in the last press conference also, when the case from Hong Kong was described. So the reinfection is very, very rare with COVID, number one. Number two, we have seen reinfection occur with, and I had given the example of measles, that someone gets measles, he is supposed to be protected all his life from measles because he generates certain antibodies which lasts. But we have seen reinfection occurring in measles as well. Similarly, we can have reinfection with the COVID, as has been described by the case in Hong Kong, and it is not a matter of serious concern. And these, whenever one point has been noted, that whenever reinfection occurs, both the infections have been mild and therefore the reinfection occurs.
Sir, the second wave, are we having a second wave? If yes, when did the first wave end? If you could just explain that. Also, from the Sero survey, what's your understanding of what happened in rural India in the month of May?
I do not know what you mean by a second wave, but what I can say is that if you look at countries of Europe and the United States, they had a peak and then they came down, and during that peak, whether it was Spain or United Kingdom or Sweden or Italy, there were a huge number of mortalities, and there was a peak which came down, and then they had some second wave which is recently occurring in those countries as well. Fortunately, we took learnings from that in India, and we were able to, what we call, distribute the curve. So I would say we distributed the curve in such a way that we did not have those deaths, that large number of deaths, and that was attributed mainly scientifically because of the very effective lockdown that was held in the months of late March, April, and May. And therefore we were able to really distribute the curve. So we didn't really have a huge peak at all from that perspective.
Download Tarang online radio app from Google Play Store.
You are listening to Tarang devotional online radio.